the Velcro strap comes where?
The seat that comes inside is a little tab there. Yeah.
Okay. There it is.
In the airlock. This is Trace Caldwell and Jim Dutton helping Rick and Clay get into their suits and get into the airlock. And here's TJ getting our safers ready. TJ was also a great help today. And of course, Dottie, she loaded us up with tools and put us to work as soon as we got out the door. These safers are backpacks that are donning right now on the spacesuit, and those allow us that if we were to fall off in some strange event, we could fly back. And the way they put us into the airlock after they put the safers on is the first person to go out the door goes in head first, and the second person goes in feet first. And then we spend a little bit of time as we wait for the pressure to go down and to be ready to open the hatch. We fiddle with our tools and we just try to get comfortable and relax a little bit before we head outside to do our EVA, and you see how many people it takes to stuff us all in there. A lot of work and effort and pre-planning goes into EVAs also. This is Stephanie Naoko in the MPLM, you know, and they're doing simultaneous operations, trying to do a lot of resupply and return supply work. And really, really busy. This is Rick coming out of the airlock. I'm sorry, this is Clay coming out of the airlock and on EVA 2.
And at the beginning, the crew members, each EVA crew member puts on a safety tether. It's sort of like a leash. You can think of it that way. And that way, they're always connected to station and we don't have to worry about them getting hurt. And there you see Rick coming out of the airlock. And so now we have both EVA crew members outside. And we do a couple of safety checks to make sure those tethers are on good and solid. And then we also make sure that the safer that we talked about, that their handles are both down. And that means that if they needed to, they could use their jetpack and fly themselves back to station. But that would be in a worst-case scenario. The robotics workstation today, getting the arm into position and working with Rick and Clay with the ammonia tank. They did a fine job again, holding it steady for us as we did a couple of grapples and a couple of releases, but the operations went very well today.
Yeah, today was just a stellar example of great teamwork. We had Stephanie and Jim on the arm, Rick and Clay outside. Dottie on the flight deck, front of the whole show, and with lots of communication, lots of practice, lots of teamwork, and a lot of help from the ground, with a lot of great planning and a year of training, they were able to execute the plan really well. This is on the CETA cart on the truss of the space station, and CETA is a crew equipment translation aid, and they were preparing this CETA cart as a temporary storage place for the ammonia tank that was going to come out of the truss on the back side. And they just handed that tank off to Stephanie and Jim on the arm, and then the old tank was going to be placed temporarily on this CETA cart while they took the new tank and took it off of the payload attach mechanism on the mobile base system and took it across and placed it in the truss. On the CETA cart some more. Basically what we had to do is to tie the old CETA cart down with six different tethers, and that kind of structurally made it sound so that in case we had to leave it overnight, but luckily we're able to get it off and store it in a more permanent location on the PO, the POA. And here we are getting ready to work with the arm folks on one of those ammonia tanks.
things that was interesting today and unique for both Rick and I was the fact that we were on the backside of the truss a lot for the station, and we found that the extremes of hot temperature and cold temperature were quite pronounced compared to our previous EVAs. I'm sure we'll be able to find out exactly why that is. We have an idea, but we'll see.
This review inside the laboratory module at the robotics workstation. Jim and I were hard at work flying the arm and trying to do our best to keep it steady as we were either going over the pin or coming off of the pin for Rick and Clay, and they were holding it steady for us. And now we're back in the MPLM with the Miracle doing transfer.
Today, we installed two experiments. One is Glacier, which is a freezer on a space station, and also the Fremont Research Facility. And because we are doing supply and return items in parallel, so sometimes we have to go behind the rack because we have stored, you know, lots of items behind the rack. So we have to rotate the rack and get items, and so lots of supplies and return items done today.
This is Stephanie and Jim again at the robotics workstation. They took turns flying the arm and helping and doing the M2 task or the helping task. And there's always, of course, time for a little camaraderie and meal. And this is back in the Russian segment in the service module. And we have three Russian cosmonauts on board. And there you have Suichi, Oleg Kotov, TJ Kramer, Naoko, Michelle Kornienko, Alexander Strochkov.
They have a great time in the SM. The SM's a great place to have meals and hang out and Buff and Fyodor Yurchikhin when I was on board Expedition 15. One of the greatest times on a space mission is the time that you can take to fellowship and have meals and play with your food and just like Suichi's doing. If you look at the bubbles closely, of course, it's also amusing our crew, too. But when you are on station, you got a lot of time to play with your food, and it's finally okay.
This is Naoko Yamazaki, who is an absolute machine when it comes to transfer. And today she's right there installing the Glacier into the lab rack. And these are large freezers that we brought up, and she installed one of those today. This is Naoko again inside the MPLM. And you can see that it's chock full of resupply racks and storage bags. And Naoko's having a great time doing it. She's really a pro at it.
Sometimes you just have to appreciate the beauty around you, and here you can see our windows on the shuttle, and we're looking at the GEM module, and we're looking at the arm moving the ammonia tank into place for the EVA crew members, Clay and Rick, to actually, looks like this time they're going to untie it down so it can move and... This is part of our detailed choreography for Earth and that fragile little atmosphere around it. Our activities today were very varied, but very team-oriented with all the transfer work that's going on, all the EVA and and to train us. It was absolutely a fantastic day and topped off by some spectacular views.